Hello, I'm back. So we are going to play the battle here against the Skaven and their general Tretch Craventail. So they have a advantage. The region is Venom Glade and the terrain will be grassland. We are defending against Clan Skyre. Alright, and they have their leader. Armored and large. Melee expert. Charge defense against large foes. Storm Vermin, Sword and Shield. 2 units of those. Death Runners. Skaven Slave Spears. 2 units of Skaven Slave Slingers. And then do a Doom Wheel. Alright, and our unit list, I have Black Ark Corsairs, Bleak Swords, 2 units, and 2 units of Dread Spears, and 2 units of Black Ark Corsairs with hand bows. Let's just start the battle. Tretch Craventail. We'll see if Alyssa can win this or if she will be defeated. Alright, so we need 350 kills before we get the Murderous Prowess. That's true for all battles, I believe. And then we have allied troop count. We have 501 units out of 586 because we have lost some due to the terrain. And because there is probably a plague in the neighborhood due to the Skaven presence. And then we have the enemy troop count. 662 out of 662, so they have the numerical advantage. Right, let's take a look at the troops. So they have some troops here. I believe all of the Dark Elf troops look like this, but if they had been allied and not a part of our faction, then they would have had their own skins, but because we confederated everyone, they have the same, but their leader is still looking like this. So it's a female leader, some kind of dreadlord or something. Alyssa herself. See how this battle will go. Dread Spears. It's good if we lose some troops. Good for the economy. So we won't get too much miners. I mean, we have too many armies. So yeah, it's good if we suicide some of them. Bleak Swords here. Black Ark Corsairs. Eight units under AA control. Start the battle. Where's the enemy? They are over there. Skaven. I wonder if it will lag, because they used to lag on huge settings. Oh, they don't seem to lag. Skaven rats. At least not yet. So they have some long distance slingers there. They throw some stuff at us. We are sending forward the black or corsairs. There we see an officer as well. They will shoot their crossbows now.
Hidden units are revealed.
Hidden units. Lee has already started against the bleak swords there. There they have their lord. And there is the doom wheel driving over our troops. Jesus Christ. No wonder they had advantage there. Otherwise we could have hold their line there. Now the thing killed all of these. They might have used some kind of explosion as well. Our troops are running away there. Even our black corsairs are being defeated here. Scared by that thing. It actually causes explosions. Their hero can do some dangerous things too, but that doom wheel is no joke. No joke. So these are the slingers. Escaping slingers. Our hero is still here. Alyssa is alone. Now she decided to run. Don't know where she went. I don't know if she survived or if she died. Owned by that doom wheel. You're far too strong. Almost a cheating unit. Steadless Hydra or a dragon. At least I had 501 men deployed, losses 452. Remaining 49, and Tretch Craven Trail had deployed 662 men, lost only 168, remaining 494. They had rats, of course, not men. That sucked. I liked Alyssa. Alright.
Withdraw.
She survived the battle, but had to withdraw. I wonder if they will hunt her down now. They might do that. Volilor. So they attack Volilor now. They are reinforced. So Tretch Craventail, who defeated Alyssa, has reinforced the army inside of the settlement, where they have clan red spears, plan retreat shields, night runners. Yeah. We will retreat. So they won't get the backup of that garrison. Loyalty critical, Alyssa, rave news, rumors have emerged that Alyssa has been talking openly of your incompetence. Worse still, it would seem that their loyalty has slipped to such a dangerous degree that there is evidence that they have made preparations to cast off the shackles of your rule. Unless you take steps to secure their loyalty, there is a strong chance that they will rebel, taking the troops under their command and forming a faction to challenge your own. And learn more. Blah, blah, blah. Loyalty critical. Tranquil. Fuck, you don't want that. Loyalty low, volley loss. Loyal again. Cladrial. Whether through the threats, promise, or shared glory, or enrichment, Cladrial is now loyal to your cause. Loyalty is no longer at low level. Right. I have a sheet happens. Count since long ago, so I can use sheets through trainers. I have a lifetime membership from like 2007 or something. Anyway, I almost feel like using it to disable loyalty issues because I hate when generals revolt. But Alyssa is defeated, so that doesn't really matter much.
Be prepared for slaughter.
Not sneaky enough.
So they sent their army back to that city. Dreadnought. Underground city. The Chaos troops have almost reached us. They are there as well. We are about to get steamrolled.
Dark and noble warrior.
Let's move Alyssa back towards Clercarond, their capital, province capital. I don't have money to recruit anything.
Bloodshed becomes me. Establish a garrison.
Let's move Volilosh back to the Twisted Blade. Maybe this Chaos army will be first. They have a larger force. We also have garrison here. But I don't know, we are probably not close enough. I hope we are, but
you obey me, thralls.
Garrison details. Twisted Blade. We have only basic troops here. Dread Spears. Dark Shards, etc. In total, 7 units.
Cruelty and violence.
So 7, we have 15 units in total, and we'll face full army of Chaos troops, including Chaos Spawn. We might be defeated there. Here we have even more Chaos troops. The reason they have spawned so many troops is because we are playing with the entire faction, and in the vanilla game you would have to like defeat all the minor factions and move up and take everything before you get this much of an empire. And the problem now is that when we started with everything, we don't have the economy to make up for that. That's why cheating in that sense would be okay, because usually if you conquer it the slow way, you start with Malekith for example, and then you conquer the other cities there, then you don't have too many armies at the start, which means you will have a good economy when you reach empire level. When you have all of this, you would have very good economy, and also you would have upgraded settlements and elite units, etc. But now when we started with everything, we still only have basic troops, and we have a bad economy because it doesn't count for all the regions. If we play the vanilla game and we took, for example, Grand, then we would get money from taking Grand, and we would get money from taking Spite Reach, and so on and so forth. But now when we started with everything, we got nothing. So we have a very bad economy, and we don't have any elite troops. We only have all the starting armies, and the Chaos spawns are supposed to spawn when we have taken everything here, because in the original game, that would mean that we have like entered late game and have elite troops, etc. But because we started with everything, just like most of the other factions, that means that this Chaos spawns probably have elite troops, and that our basic troops, even though they are numerous, will have a big problem facing these armies. So here we have another Dark Elven hero. Let's move her to the city. Favored of the Witch King. Here we have Rel Bloodhim. Chaos Warriors with dual weapons, Chaos Warriors. Chaos Mounted Warriors with javelins, Chaos Spawn. So probably dangerous. So we have 7 units plus the heroes, so 9 units, and then we have the garrison of this place. It's the Slaver's Point. We had a better garrison here. Red Spears, Bleak Swords, Dark Swords with shields, Dark Riders even. 8 plus 9, that means like 17 units will probably face 19 of theirs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. They have 18 against our 17, alright. But they have more armies. This is unfair. I mean, we have all the areas, but we certainly do not have the armies to make up for it. We might get doomed. We might need to force them to agree to peace terms. I won't do that now, but I'll look at it later. Alright. We have an agent here.
Soon I will silence that chittering.
Can't do much there. Can't do much at all.
Leaving.
Let's just move her.
Noxious potions.
Doesn't seem to be
going
able to
now.
Move a do a lot here. We do not have the money for it, right? So the Chaos armies, no, that's the High Elven ones.
Tyrant, sir, damn you.
cancelled move. Don't want war with elves just yet. Ah, so the chaos fleets have also reached this area. That was stupid of me to not see that before. In this area we have some units, including feral manticores. So we have 6 or 7 units there. Plus the garrison. Pretty good garrison. Dark riders and etc. Alright. Can't do much more now.
The cold-hearted shall overcome the cold-blooded.
I have an agent there, yes. Let's move my fleet.
I need little invitation to execute the Lustrians.
Couldn't move Dark this blade. Time. Seems to be something preventing it. Dragon Fang Mount.
I need little invitation to execute the Lustrians.
For some reason I can't move them. Alright, next turn. I might have already used
what's best for the
unit. Come on, we don't have the money. To upgrade any buildings or build anything. Here we have some armies that we can move.
Dread Lord of the Druki.
So we have some ships moving here. Neutral transport ships.
Please share your inanity.
We need an alliance. I don't need them to attack me. Oh, I don't have the money this time. Alright. Alright. Another chaos army there. Too many chaos fleets.
Cruel and deadly.
I guess we will move the army back. Because I'd rather fight those chaos troops than fight the elves for now.
Death is coming.
So, next turn. Murati, I forgot to move her. And the agent. They don't want war with the elves anyway. So he reached this area. Can't colonize, it costs too much. Search ruins then. Cuboid of the Old Ones. Throughout the world, the Old Ones left vast towers of power for use by their most trusted servants. To prevent such power falling into the wrong hands, they placed wards and cryptographic locks over them. Millennia have passed. These wards have weakened, but the arcane locks remain. To access the Old One's treasure, solve the puzzle. A die has 6 faces. May the fates keep them rolling high, especially if you're making a ward save. I really don't understand what to do with this. I don't really understand it. Let's just take something. Puzzle succeeded! Ixarian. Whether or not the Old Ones have guided your hand, you solved the puzzle. Treasury plus 1000 opal amulet. Alright, he gained an opal amulet. Hit points plus 4, ability, opal amulet, duration 60 seconds, ward save. I see, plus 20 damage resistance. It's a good item. The Elven fleet is moving. Will they attack me now? Maybe. That means war. No, they just went past. Went by me. They have other fleets that might attack. The Etain faction, the main Elven faction. We have Lizardmen fleets moving in here. They are attacking an area here. No equipment available. The battle will take place outside of the settlement. That sucks that it isn't a battle of the settlement. So we have Sabishal here, settlement garrison. They attacked an empty garrison. I mean an empty city, but they always have garrisons in this game. So we have 2 units of Bleak Swords, 2 units of Dread Spears, and 3 units of Dark Shards with shields, and we have 1 unit of Dark Riders. Pretty good, I think. But they have quite a force. They have Lord Mastamundi, their faction leader. Leader of all the Lizardmen. So he's very strong. And then they have Cricket, Temple Guards, Skink Cohorts with Javelins, Feral Bastiladen, and the Croxigore unit. They are much stronger than us, according to this. We'll still see how this will go. So let's save the game. Resume it and fight the battle on the battle map. So we are at war with the entire Lizardmen faction. I'm not as worried about them and the Skaven, because they, just like us, started with their starting units. They don't have futuristic elite units. But they of course have the hero, unique units that follow with the heroes. But the Chaos armies, they are elite, because they might think that we are in the late game now, because we have so many regions. That's very worrying. I couldn't enter diplomatic relations with the Chaos factions as long as they are on the ships. So we have 176 defending troops in the garrison out of 609 troops. For some reason they are weakened. They aren't the strongest. They aren't at full strength, as we can see here. Probably due to the terrain and other things. And then we have 330 attacking troops. You see, they aren't at their full strength for some reason. Here are the Dark Riders with swords. I believe some of them were bugged in the past, but these doesn't look bugged. They were glitched in the way that some of the swords weren't in the hands. Right, then we have some other units here. Good units, but unfortunately not that many. And officers in each unit. Sucks that they made the cities like part of the background. When you fight a battle of a city, you actually want to fight in the city and defend walls and such. You don't want to fight outside. That sucked. It means CA, Creative Assembly, was lazy. But there are some cities with custom settlements that will, as I said before, have actual custom made cities that are awesome. But unfortunately, most of the cities have either this boring layout where you fight outside of the city. That's for the minor cities that are vanilla. And then vanilla walled cities have walls, but they are very boring too. Very simple. I mean, if you look at Total War Rome 2 or Attila, etc., then they had much better city battles. In Total War Warhammer 2, they kind of neglected to make the siege battles as good as they did in Rome 2 and Attila, but everything else is just as good in Warhammer, and the modders have made awesome cities. It's kind of sad that they can't keep up with Medieval 2 in this game when it comes to the city battles. No one wants simpler city battles or siege battles. I mean, no point changing things. I would like it to be exactly like in Medieval 2, but yeah. All right. we've placed him under AI control. Start the battle. So the enemy army, they have Croxigors. They have some smaller skink javeliners here. They have this big guy. Another huge unit. What is that? Feral Bastiladon. Their faction leader himself.
By your command.
Our cavalry is now attacking. There with our infantry charging their ranks here, but they are throwing javelins. Fortunately, we have shields. Crossbowmen are firing their arrows. The Croxigors have started to kill off our lines there. That Bastiladon thing just wrecks our line there of dread spears. There are too few to handle it, but even a full unit would have trouble with that one. I just wrecks them. There is some kind of general or hero. I believe it's a hero or lord or whatever. Managed to scare away the troops there. Their leader is doing his magics. Battle is already over, as we can see. Troops are dead all around us. Blood splatter, and a few remaining units that are still alive started to rout. Yeah, we couldn't win this, we were too few. They had huge beasts and the leader himself. They took this area, but yeah, it sucks. This was a siege battle, but this minor city is in the background, really bad, I think. So Sabichal had 176 deployed, and we lost 87, 89 remain. We lost half. Lord Mastamundi had 330 men. He lost only one. Remaining 329. Alright. Total defeat too. I don't like that we have so few units defending. I'm not sure why they have so little health. Why they aren't at full strength. Maybe it's some revolts or whatever. Maybe they don't have the care they need in those cities. Sucks. If it had been at full strength, we would have been able to do some damage. But I still think they would have won. We had no hero. And they had their leader, their best hero. So. Decisive defeat. Decisive defeat. I think decisive, alright. Decisive defeat, yeah. They took that area, it's now a lizardman area. Clan Scryer and Seth's Cravenhall has attacked Venom Glade, where we have a garrison. But it's not at full strength either. I don't know why they aren't at full strength, that sucks. If it had been at full strength, we would have been able to defend properly, but unfortunately they are at very low strength. Let's just start the battle then. We will be defeated here as well. Worthless garrisons that aren't even at full strength. That sucks. I might restart the campaign and make sure that that won't be the case. Maybe there is a cheat somewhere that will force that to be at maximum health or something. It's more fun if they have maximum health. Symmetry revolts, I don't like revolts. But for now we will play without any cheat and yeah. We might actually lose because of it, because look, they have full strength and we have very weak garrisons. So we have more of the same units here. Dark Shards with shields, bleak swords, dread spears, dark riders, pretty good garrison if it weren't for the fact that they are so few. Like that. Alright. So that they have 540, we have 169. At maximum strength we would have had 609 and been more than they have. Alright, let's start the battle then.
Orders understood.
Crossbows ready here. Look cool with the shields like that. Look, the arrows look like in Medieval 2, that's very good. So it's Clan Scryer of the Skaven that are attacking again. The army that previously defeated that girl, Alyssa or whatever. Skaven armies, or cavalry is charging, or are they retreating? It looked like they were retreating. My dread spears are moving down that those tents there. Some units did good. Dread spears there, charging the enemy, fighting to the last, getting beaten. We are too few. Our crossbowmen doing well. Dark shards. Now they are. Now they're retreating. The Skaven are charging our lines. We have some troops over there in the city. Probably gain some morale boost fighting there. Let's pause the game. I don't like when I don't see the units. Looked like they were fighting in some settlement area. Tents. Here they are. So looking at the battle here, seem to be running away there. start a battle. So the Skaven's got away the defenders. They are routing. And we lost, as expected. That's the thing that was shooting beams. Not good that they aren't at full strength. So we lost that area too. Yeah, it might not be possible to play as huge empires from the start without using money sheet, because our economy can't really afford all of the areas and armies. And even if we can play the economy without cheating, we need something to prevent the garrisons from being low. Can't really afford their food and such. That's probably the reason. We don't have enough money to provide for all of the garrisons. Well, the AI unfortunately seem to be just fine. They lost 43, we lost 79, with 90 remaining out of 169. They have 471 remaining out of 514. Decisive defeat. And they attacked again. Skittish. Clan Scryer. Cladriel is attacked. The army I sent to take care of them. Now they decided to attack, but we have the upper hand in this battle. Balance of power. Greater the proportion of yellow on this bar, the greater the military superiority your army has over that of your opponent, and vice versa. You are defending against Clan Scryer. Region, the Great Arena, Terrain, Tundra. Alright, so Cladriel, who has the combined forces of her starting army and most of Hellebron's starting army, minus the unique units and Hellebron herself. We can't have more than one unique lord in an army, and I didn't want to give her Hellebron's unique units. She has everything else from their two armies. So Cladriel of Grond will fight the Skittish guy here. So they have Skittish himself, they have Feyvel Lorasis, probably some wizard there. Clan Rats with shields, Clan Rats, two units of Clan Rats, Skaven Slave Spears, Skaven Slaves. They have four units of Skaven Slaves, Night Runners, and they have two units of Skaven Slave Slingers. Alright, let's start the battle, of course. This battle we might actually win, because the army is at full strength. Cladriel of Grond. Still just a starting army. So might not have a chance against a futuristic Chaos army. Start deployment. Take a look at the army. They are not that. They are numerous this time. Numerous. So we have these guys, the Dark Shards, but they don't have shields. We have the Black Arc Corsairs with hand bows. Some lord there. Some bleak swords. Dread spears. very basic army with some medium units as well. But at least they are numerous and have all their health. Caladria herself from behind. Looks like a vanilla mage. There might be some mod involved too to make her look like this. Anyway, she looks kinda good. So that's Cladriel, leader of this force. Place under AI 12 units, so we didn't have more than 12 units, that's surprising. So in total we have allied troop count 861 of 924, probably due to terrain or something. Enemy troop count 1319, yeah, they are skaven out of 1337. So of course they have the numerical advantage. Start the battle. Here are the enemy. They're probably attacking me from the side or something. They are the ones attacking after all, so they will just show up somewhere, I believe.
I shall pluck out their eyes.
Where is the enemy? There is the enemy. And our hero is a sorceress. She can do magic, of course. So our troops are moving forward. Skaven armies coming down on them. Melee against melee here. Wonder what hero they have. Our hero, Caladriel, is doing some ice magic on the Skaven troops. Skaven rebels. They came from the sides too.
Very well.
So they came from the side here, surrounded our troops. I wonder if we can win. They have a great hero too that can kill a lot of our troops with some magics. They have a mage, that guy. We also have a mage, so it's like a mage versus a mage there. So they have the numerical advantage, but our troops would be better than they, than their troops. They have managed to rout some troops there. Look at that! Their hero is very dangerous. Let's move the camera back a little. So our troops have retreated there. They have some dangerous explosions, like chemical explosions there, killing rows of our troops. But the Black Ark Corsairs seem to still be holding fine. Bleak Swords are moving back to the front. And some of the Dread Spears as well. Let's move the camera back.
Beware,
So we have some troops fighting bravely here. Steer troops moving forward. Seems like they are winning there. Skaven are routing there. Good job, soldiers. And then here too they are breaking. And over there. Maybe we will win, even if they had the numerical advantage. I wonder where my hero is though. She should be somewhere, but I'm not sure where. Out of zoom. This beam did come from there. Have some range slingers here. Slingers. They are. Here is the hero too. Should be close. They are routing. Let's do this. I don't like when I can't see. There is their hero. Their mage. That's dangerous. He's doing there.
Vile creature.
Of course. I will succeed.
I don't know where the hero is. My hero.
Very well.
He's not dead yet, I think. Here we have some units too. He's still alive, that hero. And here is our hero, Galadriel. Dueling with their hero. Casting spells. Both of them are casting spells.
Calling the wind. I am yours.
I sense defeat.
I am determined.
He did a jump. There. Our hero is bloodied. He's trying to reach their hero for a duel. He is busy killing our troops. Hunting down some of the routing red spears there. He might be running away now. Yeah, he seems to be routing, trying to flee the battle.
Devoted to bloodshed. Very well. Claiming their soul. I will succeed.
So here is our hero.
All for Atlati.
I am waiting.
Of course. How dark. All for Hecate.
That is their hero, I think. Charge there against our Black Ark Corsairs. He's surrounded. Kill a lot of troops there in one blow. Being hurt by a lot of spears there.
My blade hungers.
I don't think he's routing yet.
Slaughter them. By Drakira.
Slay them.
Where is their hero? There he is.
End them.
I sense defeat.
Make them bleed.
So I think we have won this battle.
Death is coming. Make them bleed.
Let's see. We have lost 331 of. We have 331 left of 924. They have 168 left.
Kill everything.
They have some troops here running away from our troops. We have some bleak swords there. They're routing there as well. They have some troops here as well. No, that's our troops. Here are their troops, the slingers, I think. Throwing some stones or whatever with those things. Like, the officers have different hair. We have some dark shards in the background, shooting fire back at them.
Die, weaklings! Glorious destruction! No survivors! Attack!
They only have two units. The yellow ones are our troops.
Suffering for all. By
oh, our hero is almost dead. And victory.
Annihilate them.
Make them bleed.
Run with
blood for Cain.
Famine.
Lost a lot of troops in this battle. End the battle. And we lost half the army, at least. Our hero almost died. I think their hero died. And their they had some. Their lord died, and their hero too. Reinforce this army with the army of Malaket, I think. Or the army of the Deadwind Sentinels. I like how cinematic this game is. So we had 861 men deployed, we lost 509 men, remaining 352. They have 1319, they lost 943, They have 376 remaining. They have almost the same number remaining. Loot gain 654, that's good. XP gains, experience. Alright, Pyrrhic victory. Yeah, we won, but we lost a lot of our troops. Alright. Unit replenished. Yes, let's take slaves. Let's fast forward. We are attacked! Volilosh is attacked by Jaeger Corfex. So it's a Chaos army, but we didn't get back up from that garrison. That really sucked. Retreat. Let's retreat. Here we succeeded in reinforcing the settlement. So we have Shakara here with an army, and then we have the settlement garrison, and they had half strength, not too bad, but still not very good because they have full strength. Alright, AI control for the allied army there, the garrison. Our force is full strength, but the garrisons for some reason are not. Probably because the city couldn't provide for all of them. So we have Rel Bloodhame here of Chaos, and he has Chaos Warriors with dual weapons, he has Chaos Warriors with great weapons, Chaos Warriors, ordinary, and Chaos Knights, he has some Chaos Knights too, three of them, Chaos Mounted Warriors with javelins that they throw, Chaos Mounted Warriors, Chaos Spawn, Chaos Trolls, and a hell cannon. That's an elite army facing off against our starting armies. Yeah, we can't really play with this mod unless we use cheats, because as you see, the Chaos armies will be elite and we will still have basic stuff. I guess I will at least make sure that we will never get weakened garrisons, and also that we might actually upgrade some cities so that we have a chance against Chaos. Alright, let's go to the battle anyway. Alright, Dark Elven Empire is going to get steamrolled, I believe, from Chaos especially. I want to play the entire faction, but I don't want to face elite Chaos troops with basic Dark Elf troops. So, Dark Elven troops, so, yeah. Battle of Slaver's Point. Shakara versus Rel Bloodhame. We have 191 allies in this army too. So, allied troop count 759 out of 1,195. Enemy troop count 896 out of 896. If we had been at full strength, we would have been able to do some damage to them, but I believe they would have won anyway because of their elite armies. You can see their army, by the way. Take a look at them. So those guys are not to be underestimated. Chaos spawns. That's cheating to have an elite army. And we have basic stuff. Anyway, here are the Knights of Chaos. Knights of Chaos. Some Chaos troops here as well. Here are the Hell Cannon. It's probably not bad at all. Chaos units there, crew. More cavalry. Here are the trolls, they weren't that big. They are pretty strong, I believe. Chaos trolls. Alright, so that's their army. The Lord, where is he? Should be a legendary lord somewhere. Legendary Lord leading this army. Can't seem to find him though. Alright. Let's take a look at our troops then. Defending Slaver's Point. Have some dark shards with shields, black are corsairs. Some dark riders with swords, too few of them. Some more troops, I believe the ones at the front are the weakened garrison troops. Then we have the troops of our hero here in the back. We have numbers, but we don't have nearly as good troops. And the hero, where is she? Here's the hero. Alright, all of them are 1-4, 16 units in total. I was wrong, I thought it was 17. Alright, and start the battle. We have another hero here. Maybe that is the hero, she moved forward. They've already shot at our troops there. They took out some of our Black Arc Corsairs there. With their Hell Cannon. Look at that. Spooky. We is the battle going here? So they haven't really entered melee yet. Let's see. Can't see anything. Now I see more clearly. Ah, so my poor Dread Spears, they are fighting their guy and Chaos Spawns. Here we have some troops, Bleak Swords, fighting their Chaos Warriors. They are way bigger. And they have the Trolls entering from behind. Even more troops fighting there. Cavalry steamrolling them. So our Dark Shards have been reached by their cavalry. There is. He should be here somewhere. So he's probably there. Can't see her inside of that mess. Cavalry. Cool fire effect there. There is their leader. Their cavalry. I think this campaign is lost because we don't have nearly enough good troops against those Chaos armies. And there is the leader. And the battle is over. Big defeat, they almost lost nothing. Because they have elite troops here. Yeah. Unfair. This army is supposed to meet elite late armies. So yeah. In order to face that, we might need to use sheets. To make our settlements ready for such a war. So Shakara lost 406 out of 568, has 162 remaining. Landville lost 150 out of 191, has 41 remaining. They only lost 49 out of 904, remaining 855. Decisive defeat. Servants of Chaos have now entered land in many areas. They still have a lot of ships. Maybe the Chaos Spawns are a feature of the Radious Total Overhaul mod. And the Legendary Lords mod didn't count for these armies to spawn. The Legendary Lords mod makes all the starting armies of each race band together. That somehow manipulates the AI into spawning the elite Chaos armies, and we can't stand a chance against them with the starting armies. So I wish they wouldn't spawn based on us holding a lot of territories. That sucks. Purge, Sekulil, the debauched and the murderous Death Knight is upon us. The Hag Queens descend, vicious and desperate for sacrifice. Maybe we could appease them through a donation for them flesh. Settlement looted, Venom Glade, Obsidian Peaks, yes. Stretch Craventail of Clan Scryer has looted our captured settlement, taking a wealth of 1014. Remember this outrage and visit it on them many times over. Right unlocked, sacrifice to Cain. The victims of Cain cannot go meekly to his halls. It must be bloody-handed murder, but once the blood is flowing, from where will it stop? This rite is now available to the performed via the rite panel. Our sacrifice of Cain at the bottom right of the campaign interface. Settlement raised, Slavish Point, the Broken Lands. So we lost 4 settlements. In total, Rel Bloodhame of Servants to Chaos has razed one of our settlements to the ground. He must be made to pay for this ignominy, or whatever. Loyalty critical. Grave news, rumors have emerged that Irkitar has been talking openly of your incompetence. Alright. Settlement lost. Iron Spike. Titan Peaks. Disaster. We have lost Iron Spike to Lord Mastamundi of Hexuatl. Settlement lost. Venom Glade. Obsidian Peaks. Disaster. We have lost Venom Glade to Tretch Craven Tail of Clan Scryer. Enemy killed in battle. Favor Loyasis. Favor Loyasis, our enemy belonging to Clan Scryer, has perished in the Battle of Nagarond Iron Mountains. Wood. Killed in battle, Shakara. Surely a cruel jest by the gods. Shakara has been killed in battle at Slaver's Point, the Broken Lands. Faction destroyed. Istalia has been defeated. Istalia have been obliterated. There is nothing left apart from the echoing laughter of thirsting gods. Faction destroyed. The Tyrants of the Black Ocean. Tyrants of the Black Ocean have been obliterated. Alright. Have some buildings constructed. Halls of mustering. Construction complete. Livestock pens. Construction complete. Yeah, we have lots of buildings there. Alright. I don't really care about that. Alright. Our armies, what about
Mother of the Druki. Master of cruelty.
I am Morathi.
All right. So the Chaos armies have landed. Jäger Corfax. So can't we talk to the Chaos factions? What the fuck? So it seems we can't even speak to the Chaos factions. So we can't prevent them from continuing their onslaught.
Bloodshed becomes me.
Volilosh fled this place. Chaos armies are all over our lands now. Huge armies. Late game troops. That's totally unfair. Even if I used a cheat to upgrade my cities, they would still have the advantage. Plus, it would be unfair against other factions that do not have late armies. That's why it's Stalia and those other guys were destroyed. I believe this was a mistake of the mothers that they didn't account for the chaos spawns. Because yeah, it's fun to use everything against everything, but that chaos spawn is not great. I might actually need to play it as it's intended then. So we will not have all the areas from the start. Instead play and take one at a time, and then when we have everything we are strong enough to face the chaos attack, because playing like this we have no chance against their elite armies with our basic troops. They are everywhere. Feel like we will just be fighting a losing battle now. I need to go pee. See ya. Right. I don't know how we will be able to remove the chaos spawns. They're probably part of the Radius mod. They must activate that script probably when we have a lot of areas. I want that script deactivated, because now we will be steamrolled by the chaos troops.
Dreadlord of Naggaroth.
It would be fun to play like this against other factions, but those chaos armies are no joke. These armies are pretty much cheating. So what now?
Always seek more power.
Armies everywhere, and they have horses. They can easily run, to our army.
Onwards, onwards!
Should we try to retreat?
Dark and noble warrior.
Like the Carcaron there.
Vicious
Lisa
warrior.
Enter the city here. Ridding the map of the chaos forces by using a cheat which will make them very weak when I click on them. Unfortunately, when I moved Lockheer Fellheart through the seas, I came across some treasure, and they said I should loot it or leave it be, and only a fool would leave it as it was. And when I clicked on looting it or taking it or whatever, I ended up in this situation, battle deployment. So I'm attacked by Harold Knotts. He has he's himself the general, and then he has depth guards, zombie pirate deckhands, mob, and we have some zombie pirate and we have zombie pirate gunner mob, zombie pirate gunners mob, hand cannons, pirate gunner mob. I didn't want to face an army, but I can't retreat, and seeing as he is Lockheer Fellheart is at a disadvantage, I had no choice but to fight the battle. We might lose actually.
Raid, fight,
fight the battle on the battle map then. I'm still not done reading the map of the Chaos Forces. I'm using a sheet so I can move unlimited. I have unlimited movement points so I can move through the entire map. No other way to, you know, survive this elite Chaos Forces. We will play without cheats, but we need to remove those Chaos armies. So, allied troop count 391, 400. 391 out of 400, and enemy troop count 964 out of 964. And failure Lockhart's army. So he has some dark shards with shields here. And he has some black arc corsairs with hand bows. Some dread spears. As usual, and some bleak swords. He also has a manticore, feral manticore, I believe. Is the name? Yeah. Feral manticore here. Great beast. Didn't want to lose this army without having the battle recorded. Fairy Lockhart himself. So this is the leader. His helmet looks like a squid or octopus. So he has leveled up since the last time. I believe he is let's see, he might be just level 1. I don't think so. Oh, I could move them like that. Nice. I could control them like that, but there is one button that doesn't work now. So I change stuff. Alright.
Nagaroth! It will be!
What the fuck is happening? This is some odd looking creatures. I've never fought against these before. Zombies and cannoneers and stuff. Some zombies there. Manticore is doing a good job slaying their troops there. Alright, here we have Feller Lockhart himself. Feller, whatever. The undead are fighting our troops here. We have no sheets activated, so we might lose. No sheets in the battle. That's the zombies there. There they have their cannoneers, hand cannoneers. Crossbowman here in the back. Dark charge.
Let others die.
There seem to be many. Manticore is still fighting over there. Here's their leader. Don't remember his name. Leader's probably there fighting their troops. So I didn't want to fight this battle, but we had no choice. Look at the carnage. Warriors all alone here. Zombies are charging our Black Ark Corsairs. We are being slayed in the masses. Even shot at from far. Manticore is still around. There are too many. I knew we would lose. Look at that. They have gunners. Yeah, we lost this battle. And the battle. Alright, close defeat. So we had deployed 391 men and we lost 333. We have 58 remaining. Harold Knotts had 994, way more than us. And he lost 338. We still killed more than we had. Remaining 656. Didn't want to record until I had read the map of the Chaos Forces, but I made an exception now. So we will record some after the battle too, but then I will stop recording and continue my mission of reading the map of those Chaos armies, because they were elites, so we would have no chance. Then I will return all the troops of my faction to their original start positions and continue the campaign. Of course, this means that the Chaos armies will not spawn late game, because they are already removed. But all the other factions will have, you know, normal strength. So we will continue the campaign and fight others. But the Chaos invasion is kind of disabled. We would have no chance against Chaos. So these were the rogue pirates. Close defeat.
Why, my friend? Why?
Alright. See you soon.